Good evening and welcome to Kaleidoscope. This is an informative news magazine program featuring events around and in the Mohawk Valley. Your hosts for tonight's show are Al Gregory and Joe Salvatore.
Good evening and welcome to Kaleidoscope. On the Steam Needs program, we'll be covering a variety of topics. We'll take a look at an on-the-street survey done by our reporter Julie Davis in the Mohawk Valley. Joe?
Thanks, Al. Kaleidoscope's cameras captured Lieutenant Governor Maryanne Krupczak's recent speech in our area, and we'll have an exclusive report on the Herkimer County Ambulance Service. We'll have those stories and more as Kaleidoscope continues.
The Special Olympics is trying to develop the lives of these children and young adults through successful experiences in sports. The competition, consisting of swimming, gymnastics, and many other events, is open to anyone 8 years of age or older. Volunteers and donations are desperately needed, so please call 866-6040 or write to Herkimer County BOCES in East Herkimer.
Do you consider yourself a conservative, liberal, or moderate? Based on a New York Times survey which asked a series of questions dealing with fundamental political issues, our reporter Julie Davis asked these questions on abortion, marijuana. According to our residential political scientist at Herkimer County Community College, Dr. Jack Christensen, people will classify themselves as a conservative, but operationally they are something else. Conservatives are against abortion, legalized marijuana, and giving up on the Panama Canal, while liberals say yes to all three. And now here's Julie's story.
Marijuana.
Would you classify yourself as a conservative, a moderate, or a liberal?
A conservative.
Okay. And what do you think about the Panama Canal? Do you think that maybe we should have given it back to the Panamanians or kept it for ourselves?
I believe giving it back to the Panamanians.
Yeah. Okay, and what do you think about the decriminalization of marijuana?
That's a little bit difficult to answer. I don't approve of marijuana, but from what I read, they're quite strict. In fact, I think they go a little bit overboard with what they do to the young people that get involved with it.
Mm-hmm. And do you feel right about the legalization of abortions?
Yes, because I feel sorry for the poor people that can't afford to have so many children, and they have no other way to turn. For myself personally, I wouldn't believe in abortion, but for those, I think it's the right of a woman to make up her mind what she wants to do with her own body.
Okay, thank you very much. Self, a conservative, a liberal, or a moderate?
I think considerate.
You mean
I could have said conservative.
Conservative.
Uh-huh, conservative, yeah.
Okay. What do you think about the Panama Canal? Do you think that the United States should have given it up to the Panamanians?
No, absolutely not.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what do you feel about the legalization of abortions? Do you think it's right?
I think that would surely be up to the individual person.
Mm-hmm.
I think they have a right to do, the woman has a right to do whatever she feels is right for her.
Yeah.
I really don't believe in it. I don't believe in taking a life. But still, I think it's up to the individual person. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
And what do you think about marijuana? Do you think that it should be decriminalized?
No, I don't think so.
Liberal or moderate?
Conservative.
Okay. And what do you think about the Panama Canal? Do you think that we should have given it back to the Panamanians?
I don't think we should have, no.
No? And what do you feel about abortions? Do you think that they should be legalized?
Only where it would concern the life of the mother.
Mm-hmm. And what do you feel about marijuana? Do you think that it should be decriminalized?
No, I feel it should be left the way it is.
Or moderate?
Moderate.
Okay, what does it mean to you, being a moderate?
I really don't know, to tell you the truth.
Okay, what do you think about the Panama Canal? Do you think that it was right for us to give it back to the Panamanians?
No.
No?
No.
Why? Why do you say that?
Because it was ours, and it has been for a long time.
Yeah. What do you think about abortions? Do you think that it was right to legalize abortions?
No.
You don't feel that way?
No, because it's not the baby's fault what happened.
Yeah. And what do you think about marijuana? Do you think that it should be decriminalized?
I don't know, really.
Well, I'm moderate in everything.
Uh-huh.
Politics and just about everything. I don't, I'm not liberal, that's for sure.
What do you think about the Panama Canal? Do you think that it was right for us to give it back?
No. No, I don't. I don't think at all. I think they should have let us vote on that. I really do.
Yeah. What do you think about abortions? Do you think that they should be, do you think it was right to legalize abortions?
For those that want it. I wouldn't do it myself, and I wouldn't say that you could or you couldn't. There are circumstances where they should, but I wouldn't want to have to face God after doing that.
Yeah. And what do you think about marijuana? Do you think that it should be decriminalized?
No.
No?
No, I don't.
I'm not sure about that.
Sure. Okay, what do you think about the Panama Canal? Do you think that we should have given it back to the Panamanians?
Yes, I do.
Why do you feel that way?
Because it was theirs to begin with, in a way. It was in their territory. I think we should have given it back to them.
And what do you think about abortions? Do you think that it was right to legalize abortion?
Only if a woman had to have an abortion due to medical reasons. Otherwise, I don't agree with abortions at all.
And what do you think about marijuana? Do you think that it's right to decriminalize marijuana?
No, no, I don't.
Why do you feel that way?
Because I consider it part of drugs anyways, and I'm totally against drugs.
Moderate.
Conservative.
Conservative. Mm-hmm. Why do you say that?
I don't know. I just feel that way.
Okay. And what do you think about the Panama Canal? Do you think it was right to give the canal back to the Panamanians?
Yes. Yes.
To legalize it?
Well, I sort of against it, so I don't think it was right to legalize.
And what do you feel about marijuana? Do you think that it would be right to decriminalize it?
I'm against it.
We'll be back with more Kaleidoscope after this.
Lung disease kills and cripples. It's striking a countless number of victims every day. We, the American Lung Association of Mid-New York, are fighting this disease, but we need your support. If you are a health professional, your volunteer time would be of great benefit to the victims of emphysema or other types of lung disease. But more importantly, we need your financial support. The American Lung Association is funded through Christmas Seal contributions, so please give while you can.
Lieutenant Governor Marianne Krupczak recently spoke at the Herkimer Chamber of Commerce's annual dinner, and she has some encouraging news on the state's economy, and here's what she had to say.
It gives me a great pleasure to bring to you our honorable Lieutenant Governor of our great state of New York, Marianne Krupczak. Let's give her a big hand.
Home. And Congressman Pretty, I'm going to talk with you on our way out because it's wonderful to be able to see you again. I think about all the days of all of our working together, and it's a thrill to be able to be back in the area on an occasion such as this. It's exciting to see what Don had to say about the area, and I couldn't agree more. The perspective that one gets in the travels that are just a part of this job makes one so aware of what we have in this Mohawk Valley. The chamber asked me to concentrate a little bit about tourism, but I can't help but say for a moment, because I feel a little stake in the success of the Herkimer Library Bureau, and I'm just thrilled to see that venture going so well, seeing it such a success, and new jobs coming on board because of the strength and the viability of this corporation. Do you remember those dark days when this county wondered whether there would be a survival of that fantastic institution that provided jobs and quality product? Do you remember how tough it was? Do you remember how you earned the respect and the admiration of this country for having proven that it could be done? That people pulling together and getting together could make something happen? What an example, not only for this state, but for this country. I remember Walter Cronkite with his pictures of Herkimer, showing the success of a self-help effort for economic development and economic revitalization. We've had our tough times. We're not out of the doldrums by any shot. The Assemblyman and I know very well the struggles that we've had, and we've hammered out in that bipartisan environment there a kind of policy which I think is beginning to pay off. It's good to see the $9 million investment that Remington Arms is making and the near finished expansion. It's good to hear of the area economy improving with some companies coming in for a change. Our Commerce Department told me that a firm is bringing in a new division from its Ohio plant soon. It's this kind of thing that we can look forward to. I hope those dark days are over. I was telling Charlotte that when we were growing up in this area, in the late 40s and early 50s, as I came home from college, the kind of mood of despair that so many of us had about our economy, and probably in those worst of days, and it seems to me in the past 7 years when we lost so many corporations and we seem to be having no end to this. But it's really a thrill to be able to tell you, as I get the perspective of what's happening. It's happening here. We're having that industrial base revitalized, but it's happening in lots of places. I attended a dinner in New York City about a month ago. It was attended by leading corporate chairmen of boards and directors of companies. And the principal award winner that night and the speaker of the evening was the chairman of the board of Pfizer Corporation, a major drug company that has its main headquarters in New York. And not from my lips, but from his lips, he talked about the cold analysis that his company had to make when their lease was finished this year, and they set their people to work taking a look at those so-called greener pastures elsewhere. And they took a look at their balance sheet, and they took a look at the things that had been happening, and with the good help of the legislature and with the strong direction that I believe the governor has made in many of the policies he's advocated, we have today the best tax incentive program for business. We have the best special assistance programs for business anywhere in this country. And the chairman of Pfizer said it too. He said when it was all over, they took a look at it and they decided to sign another 17-year lease on their property in New York. There are 23 new Canadian firms in Batavia. There are things that are happening all over the state, and in this past year alone, we have a net increase of 40,000 manufacturing jobs. There are 127 craftspeople, and this map puts the point right on the map in the North Country. It gives you the address, and it tells you what days of the week they're open and what hours. And this is a challenge that I put out. My office did this on their own time, and we all pitched in on it. We got together, we found the craftspeople, and they found each other, and we put this together. And I wanted to do it especially for the Adirondacks, because this has been a tough area, and it's a beautiful area, and it has a lot of these craftspeople. I was telling our friends here, they're just new to New York, and I'm telling them all the places that they should go and see. Do you know that the man who designed the Walt Disney figures, the original craftsperson who designed those figures, is a New Yorker? He left to go to Hollywood for a good part of his career, but he's retired now in the North Country, and he's up there, and he still works part-time, and he makes toys. And what an exciting place to take your kids for a ride. Well, we have it all. I'm a chauvinist as far as New York comes, because I do love New York. I think we all love New York. And I think there's a part of it, and a great part of it, for Herkimer County. This is that map. If you want some, I still have some in my office. It's being reprinted again. I promise to leave it to our newest residents in Herkimer County. But be as proud as we all are of New York, because we're on our way, and we do have something well worth being proud about. Thank you very much.
Thanks. That was Lieutenant Governor Marianne Krupczak. Our reporters spoke to the owner of the Herkimer County Ambulance Service and also some residents of Herkimer County. Here's what they had to say.
The Herkimer County Ambulance System, a private corporation that guards against our lives and others. Well, they're supposed to be there when you need them, but we've had reports that sometimes it takes 1/2 hour to an hour or more to get to a scene of an accident, which could cost someone their life. Today, Kaleidoscope is going to look into this and see if we can find the answer to the question that could be a matter of life and death. We're talking to Joseph Kuchinski. I knew I'd blow it. And he is the owner of Herkimer, what is it,
Herkimer County Ambulance Service.
Okay. And first of all, what areas of the county do you serve?
Herkimer, Mohawk, Ilion, the outskirts of Ilion and Frankfort, and halfway to Little Falls and halfway to Meadowville.
And right now you have how many ambulances?
We run 2 ambulances full time.
Right, and so you are not affiliated with the county or anything?
No, we're a private ambulance service. We just use the name Herkimer County.
Okay, how long would you say, or how many calls do you receive during the course of a week on an average?
On the average, we do probably around 20 calls a week.
And most of those calls are in the general area?
Most of the calls are in the general area. 90% of the calls are routine transfer calls, about 10% of our emergency calls.
Right, and say there was an accident, say on the other side of Herkimer and on Route 5, how long would you say that it would take the ambulance to get there?
Well, if there was an accident during the day on Route 5 on the other side, probably about a minute and a half, 2 minutes at the most. Right. But if it was at night, if we had to get out of bed, probably be about 5 minutes.
I would say maybe about 15, 20 minutes.
There. It took the ambulance over 45 minutes to arrive on the scene, and it was...
You transport to quite distances?
Yeah, we transport any place anybody wants to go. And most of our transfer work is between the local hospitals in Utica, Syracuse, Albany. But we will go anywhere anybody wants to be transferred, out of state, anywhere.
So any type of accident or any type of disaster that happens that needs ambulance assistance within Herkimer, say, you are the ambulance.
Right, we're the only ambulance service. There's an ambulance in Ilion, but it's a village ambulance. So we cover all the outskirts around here and all the accidents, all the emergency works we take care of around here.
And you employ how many people?
We employ 3 full-time employees and about 5 part-time employees.
Saying two accidents occurred at the same time, what would happen then?
Well, we would send 2 ambulances, one to each accident. We would call the extra part-time help and they would take care of the other accident. And if there was something big, like we had one time on a throughway, a big bus accident, we would call in all the other ambulances in the area, like Little Falls, Ilion, Frankfort.
And okay, say if you had to call the other backup driver, would he be able to get here in ample, very fast
amount
of time?
Well, it depends how fast you consider fast. I mean, it would probably take him 5 minutes, 7 minutes to get down here. But if we had more full-time help, which we don't have the money to operate with, to have more full-time help, this is the best thing we have right now.
Okay, thank you very much for talking to us today.
Thank you.
Okay. My husband was in our backyard, and he suffered a stroke, and he was on the other side of a fence. It was a great big fence. I couldn't get to him. And I called the ambulance, and people next door called the ambulance for me because I was too nervous.
This was the ambulance here in Herkimer?
Yes, and they came immediately, and they took him to the hospital. They put him in intensive care because they thought he had a heart attack. And
but
I had very good results.
It was how long would you say it took the ambulance to get there?
I would say maybe about 15, 20 minutes.
Okay, Jim, what has your experience been with the Herkimer County Ambulance Service?
Well, in the middle of February, we had a beer blast up here at the school, and I was coming down the hill from the beer blast. We crossed Route 5. We're getting gas at a gas station. A friend of mine who had a CB in his car. We heard there was an accident just past the red light going out of town on Route 5, about 2 blocks from the ambulance corps headquarters. So we went to the scene hoping we could help, and we could. We called the police on my friend CB that was in his car, and they said that they would get an ambulance. I checked the man over inside the car to find out if he was breathing and everything. He was okay. He was cut up very badly on the left side of his face. There's a lot of glass and a large cut up above his forehead. I started to try to stop the bleeding, make sure he was breathing, and just keep him as comfortable as possible. Got some blankets from some bystanders. The police arrived about 10 minutes after the accident, after we did.
Now, you've had some first aid experience, right?
Just in high school. I had some first aid training in high school. I'm not certified for first aid, but I've had some first aid training. So I knew I could tell what to do and how to react. But when the police got there, I told the policeman to take over. He told me I was doing fine, just to stay with the man until he regained consciousness, until the ambulance got there. It took the ambulance over 45 minutes to arrive on the scene, and it wasn't even the Herkimer ambulance. It was the Alien Ambulance Corps that had to come to the scene because I don't know why, but...
Okay, the Herkimer ambulance is only two blocks away, and the Alien ambulance arrived instead.
That's right, about 45 to 50 minutes after we arrived at the scene.
And do you think that the lateness of the ambulance had anything to do with the injuries that the man did sustain? Did it?
He was lucky because they were just minor cuts and abrasions. If there had been any serious damage, no one would have been able to do anything for him, because the policeman would have had to perform first aid, or else I would have had to perform more elaborate first aid than just keeping him comfortable, and which I couldn't have done because I'm not trained to do that kind of first aid. So, therefore, if anything serious had been wrong, he may have lost his life.
Mm-hmm. Thank you very much, Jim.
Should monies for the Erie Canal be federally funded or not? It's a serious debate going on in the Senate right now. Tonight we'll take a look at both sides, for and against.
The historic Mohawk Valley, the birthplace of democracy. The relics of General Herkimer and other heroes can be seen throughout our valley. Plan a visit to the roots of our nation, a trace of the revolution, a trace of American heroism.
This evening we'll take an editorial look at for and against funding for the Erie Canal. First of all, a proposal by Senator Daniel Monahan to allocate federal funds for the state barge canal is a good idea. The canal, which is solely built, owned and operated by New York State, should receive some sort of federal aid. But better known as the Erie Canal, this waterway is vital to the economy of this entire state. Loss of jobs, higher transportation costs, and increased governmental control is not what the people of this state need. Hearings have been held in which it was reported that the state's inland waterways are in trouble. Tonnage is down due to unreliability and mechanical problems that have deteriorated. Time is running out. $200 million is needed to rehabilitate the canal system, but a snag is developing. The Army Corps of Engineers are blocking the funds, saying that it is outdated. And to top it off, New Yorkers right now are subsidizing other waterways throughout the county. The time has come to save the barge. Make that the Erie Canal.
I agree, Al. I also think that the canal should be saved, but not with federal aid. This would be a major mistake, because the Army Corps of Engineering reports that the system will collapse in 10 years and is unsettling. But in this new day and age of technology, more viable means of transporting bulk goods should be found. A waterway that has been in existence since the early 1800s should be considered for more tourism interest, with a return to lighter goods being transported. Heavy materials is very costly to move, and the barge canal is unsuitable compared to the St. Lawrence Seaway and the Hudson. $200 million to rehabilitate an outdated facility is senseless. Funds to save the canal from total collapse should come from increased tolls and the ferry services. The Erie Canal should not be just another burden to the federal government. We shouldn't be giving away various amounts of one of the state's most self-serving resources. That's it for Kaleidoscope tonight. I'm Joel Salvatore. Good evening.
This has been the last edition of the Kaleidoscope series. The TV students of HCCC hope you have enjoyed the programs this semester. Have a pleasant evening.
The American Red Cross.
We aid victims of disasters by providing clothing and a place to stay.
We offer first aid and water safety courses to qualify people to help in emergencies.
We sponsor blood clinics so people who need blood get it.
Isn't it nice to know that there's someone there when you need them?
Your good neighbor is the Mohawk Valley chapter of the American Red Cross in Herkimer.